नमस्कार, आज इंडिया डेयर्स में हम बात करेंगे एक अजीम शख्सियत से, एक ऐसी शख्सियत जिसको डिफ़ाइन करना बहुत मुश्किल है। वो ऑथर भी हैं, वो म्यूजिशियन भी हैं, वो जर्नलिस्ट भी रह चुकी हैं, वो पायलट भी हैं। थैंक्स अ लॉट संगीता फॉर गिविंग योर टाइम टू टॉक टू अस।
प्लेजर।
तो हम व्हाट्स योर फुल नेम? आई मीन आपकी किताब के ऊपर एक बहुत लंबा नाम लिखा हुआ है, व्हाट इज योर एक्चुअल फुल नेम?
देखिए, पिताजी ने तो नाम संगीता रखा था, बहुत सिंपल। लेकिन जब हम बड़े हुए और कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बने तो हमने उनका नाम पद्मनाभन अपना इनिशियल बना लिया। फिर उनका सरनेम मेनन भी हमने फैमिली नेम ले लिया। फिर हमारी शादी हो गई, मल्हन हस्बैंड का सरनेम भी ले लिया। इनफैक्ट टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया जहाँ मैं जर्नलिस्ट थी, पीपल वुड आस्क मी, How will you maintain such a long name?
Okay.
And I told them, just see how it goes. You know, it happens. It will happen. All four portions of the name will remain with me.
Okay.
So Sangeeta P. Menon Malhan is the name I've been using as a writer since 1992.
Okay. Abhi, how do I define you? What is your latest avatar?
The latest avatar, I think, is a musician, songwriter, guitarist, singer. And content creator. I've been creating a lot of content over the last 6 months.
Okay.
And my album's coming out. I released my first song last November on my last birthday. And now the other songs are coming, which are all multilingual.
Okay.
That song was Hindi Urdu.
Okay.
But the next song is English and French. The song after that is German. Thereafter, you know, and then there is a Spanish English. So multiple languages mein songs likhe hain, गाए हैं, कंपोज किए हैं और अब धीरे धीरे वो आएंगे।
सो हाउ दिस ट्रांजिशन, यू नो, यू स्टार्टेड एज अ पायलट।
यस।
टेल अस समथिंग अबाउट योर बीइंग अ पायलट।
वेल, आई वाज इन द एनसीसी व्हेन आई वाज 19 और सो इन द लेट 80s।
ओके।
एंड इन द एनसीसी देयर वाज एन ऑप्शन टू जॉइन द एयर विंग एंड लर्न हाउ टू ग्लाइड।
ओके।
सो आई लर्नड हाउ टू ग्लाइड, आई फॉट अ नेशनल कॉम्पिटिशन, वन द गोल्ड मेडल। सो आई वाज इंडियाज ग्लाइडिंग चैंपियन फॉर 86-87। And then I attended the Republic Day Parade. That was a part of the story. Thereafter, I continued my flying and I did my private pilot's license. But in Rajasthan, my parents were there at that point. They're still there. So I studied flying in Rajasthan.
Okay.
And then the flying school kind of went into disarray. Mm-hmm. One of the aircraft crashed. There wasn't enough flying happening. My theory papers started lapsing, which I had already cleared. So I had to take another call on shifting my career. And the next best thing that I was good at was writing. Instinctively, a lot of writers in my family. My father was a journalist as well. Father's elder brother was both editors. So I started writing without any training as such. And that's it, 1991, 92, I started writing. Moved to Delhi, joined the Midday, joined the Statesman, then joined the Times, where I was for 10 years. So then for 10 years, I was a journalist.
Okay. Anything remarkable that you remember about those 10 years? Anything special?
Every day was fantastic. Journalism is a great career.
Okay.
Every day you're writing something new, you're trying to understand something new, because you can't write what you don't know. You can't do stuff that you don't know. That means you have to be very thorough.
Currently, when you see journalism, there's a lot of audiovisual content. There are hundreds of channels. They are shouting, you know, matches as debates. So, I mean, what is this transition and how do you relate to this new avatar of journalism and these channels?
One of the Greek philosophers, either Socrates or Plato or Aristotle perhaps, had said long ago that we get the government that we deserve. Similarly, we get a media that we deserve.
Okay.
So in the 90s, when we started liberalizing and opening up and suddenly saw so many influences, human beings, people in India who were very simple, who were happy with, maybe not happy with Doordarshan and whatever small stuff, got very greedy with more stuff coming in. We wanted more. And then it's a cyclical effect. You want more, the media's come up, the competition arises, TRP comes into question, you give people tabloid journalism, and that sells. The same thing happened in Britain. The book I've written is on the media.
Journalism
has changed, and not
so
for the better.
So what is this book, TOI story, all about?
The story of how Bennett Coleman made the Times Group the most profitable company in this country and changed the paradigm of all media. All media functioning was changed by Bennett Coleman. in the beginning from the late 80s and more so in the 90s. So 84 se transition shuru hua tha. The period I studied was 84 to 94. And that's how this book came out, The Story of the TOI. How one organization was able to change. Of course, India Today did a lot of great stuff as well. But because of the clout of Bennett Coleman, it was able to... Aaj ka jo media hai, wo template Times Group ne 80s aur 90s mein dala tha. Ye wo journalism hai.
Aap Times Now se relate kar paate hain apne aap ko? It's a channel and it belongs to the TOI group?
It doesn't... No, I don't relate to any of these channels really.
Okay.
Because...
Well, it belongs to the same group where you work.
It doesn't matter. I'm very objective about my life and my work.
Okay.
The channels... In their same thing, in their eagerness or over-enthusiasm to stay relevant and profitable, sometimes go down the tabloid route. And it's not easy to survive, like any industry. You have to play to the masses. You can't always be very classy.
Do you somewhere feel it is because of the liberalization policy and the capitalist values coming in after 91?
No, wo to bahut, it's a very generic term. It's a very simple cause and effect story. You want more readers or audience. The audience, what does it want? It wants stuff that it can understand. Don't give it a serious lecture. Give it something it can relate to. Today, if I speak about agriculture in this country, if I speak about the Sushant Singh story, 90% janta will watch the Sushant story because easy hai, light on the head hai. It doesn't make you think. That's the worst thing. The journalism in this country is not helping people think. Of course, this parallel journalism online, which is brilliant. A lot of, digital media is doing great work. But the traditional media, I don't know. Print still has quality because you have some fantastic newspapers, Express, Telegraph, Hindu. Some amazing stuff comes out. But television, I think it's just drowning in its own, muck.
Okay. What is the future you feel? What do you feel is going to happen next? I mean, I think we have touched an all bottom low, you know, with the shouting brigades every day at the prime time. You've got 6-7 people sitting with an anchor and everybody shouts out. Nothing logical is spoken. Nothing can be heard. So what is the future?
Har daur ek daur aata hai. Ab wo ye chillam chilli ka daur shuru ho gaya hai. So a lot of extremism is happening on television. Even us as consumers of news, we are also very emotional. It's very easy to stoke our passions. I think this will continue for a long time. But fortunately, there is balance in the digital space and print tries to be balanced. I mean, it comes up with analysis and all. The future is, people say, and they predict, and sometimes it goes completely wrong. They predicted some years ago that print will die. Print is not dead. Print will not die. Digital space pe bahut kaam hoga, and the domination will be in the digital space.
Okay.
As it should be. It's far more democratic.
So this was your first book, I believe, the TOI story.
This is my third book.
This is your third book.
I wrote it first, okay. But it got published third.
Okay. What about the other three books?
The first book was a collection of short stories for young adults.
Okay.
And it was published by the Writers Workshop in Calcutta. It's a very esteemed publishing house. Doesn't publish kachra stuff. If you have to clear Professor P. Lal, he's passed away now. Mm. He's a professor of English there. Mm. Unki scrutiny se aap jab guzrenge to aapki book publish hogi. Wo hua. Then I wrote a book of poems in Urdu, because I write Urdu poetry.
Okay. How many languages do you know?
I'm studying 10 languages.
Okay, 10 languages.
So I will call myself a student of all 10, including English.
Okay.
I teach French and Spanish, but that also I teach as a student.
Okay.
So I'm a scholar-student kind of person.
Okay.
So yeah, so I did Urdu, and then this came out, this got published, HarperCollins.
Okay.
Then the fourth book was another collection of short stories, but very dark short stories.
Okay.
For adults. That came out in 2018. Mm. So the next book that I'm looking at is a travelogue. Now the travelogue is fluid under these conditions. You can't have physical books. It's a pointless.
Yes.
I might convert the whole thing into a podcast kind of thing.
Okay.
You know, it could become a travel podcast.
Okay.
That covers 10 of the greatest, most historical cities of the world that I've had the honor of visiting. Varanasi, Beijing, Cairo, Istanbul, Athens, Rome. Is tarah ki cities humne dekhi. In the last 4 years, I was able to travel a lot. So historical cities of the world pe ye travelogue hai.
All this that we talked of and all the work that you did, whether it was for Times of India, it was as a journalist, it was as an author, ye sare bade serious issues rahe hain jis pe aapne kaam kiya, likha, kuch socha, aapse baat ki to bhi laga ki you know you are an avid thinker aur aap kuch thoda future bhi soch rahe ho ki aage kya hone ja raha hai. Is sab ke beech mein music aur creativity kahan se aa gayi?
देखिए नाम ही संगीता है. तो म्यूज़िक तो जहन में रह है ही, बहता ही है बचपन से. बचपन तो नहीं, लेट मी से 10-12 की उम्र से गा रहे हैं. आई ग्रू अप इन द साउथ, सो द टेम्पल्स ऑलवेज हैव द चैंटिंग एंड द म्यूज़िक ना. आई ग्रू अप इन मदुरई, तमिलनाडु, बॉर्न इन केरला टू अ मलयाली फादर एंड अ सिख सदानी मदर, सो दैट कॉम्बिनेशन. बट ग्रू अप इन तमिलनाडु, therefore the polyglot, the multi-language. I would hear the music, and my father was a musical lover.
Okay.
In the south he would be listening to Kishore Kumar songs. Okay. In the 70s to ghar mein wo radio ya kuch chalta rehta tha, hindi gaane. To wo sunte sunte I somehow started with Urdu ghazals.
Okay.
I don't know why I went from hindi straight into
You think Urdu is more creative?
Urdu is the most fantastic language in the world, intoxicating, difficult to study, difficult to acquire, but the most magical language in the world is Urdu.
And the 1970s and
gaana gaate the, but father ne ye kaha us samay ki aap gaana hi padhna chahte hain or do you want to do something else in life. So I interpreted it as if you know music, he didn't want me to do music. So I moved away from it, but then later I just started singing on my own when I came to Delhi. My husband's a great fan of music, that helps. So there's a lot of music, that's why you have this projector, there's a karaoke in the house, so we sing here a lot. So we started singing again and I realized I can still sing. So every party I would sing. For the last 25 years I've been entertaining my friends, I've been singing. Then suddenly one day I started writing lyrics and then the music came into my head. I composed the song. I am learning the guitar. Like everything I do, I will say I learn because that's my nature. My guitar instructor once brought some notes to say, ye notes baja ke dekhiye. When I heard the notes, I wrote a song and that became my first song. We composed it there and then, and thereafter गाने खुद लिखे जाते हैं ऐसे बैठे बैठे. सडनली कब आपकी उंगली चल रही है आपको भी इल्म नहीं है.
संगीता जी, अब मैं चाहूँगा कि आपने जो लिखा है खासकर उर्दू, बिकॉज उर्दू सीम्स टू बी द क्लोजेस्ट टू यू, तो उर्दू में कुछ लिखा है तो यू नो फॉर आवर व्यूअर्स इफ यू कैन जस्ट यू नो रिसाइट इट फॉर अस.
ठीक है, ये अभी हाल ही में लिखा है, इसका नाम है नज़दीकियाँ.
ओके.
इतना भी ना करीब आओ कि संभल जाना पड़े, इतना भी न करीब आओ कि संभल जाना पड़े, नज़र यूं न मिलाओ कि कतराना पड़े. टूटे आईने में न सूरत तलाश कर मेरी, मैं वो नहीं कि जिसे भूल जाना पड़े. जहन में रहता है ना, इंसान का इंसान से कुछ तो तकल्लुफ़ रहे, कुछ खुद बूझो तुम कुछ हमें समझाना पड़े. विल डू टू मोर लाइन्स एंड स्टॉप. कब बरसती है नूर मोहब्बत खुद ब खुद, यूँ भी कभी कभी कमबख्त को आजमाना पड़े.
बहुत खूब, बहुत अच्छा लिखा आपने. और उर्दू वाली किताब का आपके क्या नाम था जो आपने उर्दू में जो पोइट्री लिखी है?
इट वाज कॉल्ड नुसरत-ए-गम.
नुसरत-ए-गम,
हाँ, द ट्रायम्फ ऑफ ग्रीफ.
ओके.
क्योंकि उससे पहले क्या हुआ कि हम इस किताब पे TOI स्टोरी मीडिया की किताब पे काम कर रहे थे और एक वक्त यूँ आया कि पब्लिशर्स कह रहे थे कि हम इसको पब्लिश नहीं कर पाएंगे. TOI के खिलाफ कौन खड़े होगा? पेनेट कोलमन के खिलाफ. तो किताब को बैक बर्नर पे डालना पड़ा कुछ टाइम तक. एंड आउट ऑफ दैट ग्रीफ केम द उर्दू पोएट्री. तो इस ग्रीफ ने हमें शायरा बना दिया. हमारी उर्दू की कोई ट्रेनिंग नहीं थी, हमने उर्दू सीखा किताब छप जाने के बाद, हमने देवनागरी में उर्दू लिखा।
अच्छा।
और जिसने पब्लिश किया उन्होंने फिर उसको उर्दू स्क्रिप्ट में लिखा।
अच्छा।
लेकिन जब रिव्यूज आने लगे तब पढ़ने के लिए फिर हमने उर्दू सीखा, स्क्रिप्ट सीखा, एक साल लगा के उर्दू का स्क्रिप्ट सीखा।
दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। टेल अस समथिंग अबाउट यू नो द 2016 पार्ट ऑफ योर लाइफ एंड यू नो हाउ यू फॉट, यू स्ट्रगल्ड एंड यू सर्वाइव्ड।
सो 2016 वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, आई वाज स्टडीइंग स्पैनिश एट दैट पॉइंट, आई वाज जस्ट अबाउट टू फिनिश माय लास्ट लेवल एंड आई काइंड ऑफ फेल्ट अनइजी, व्हाटएवर, गॉट इट चेक्ड। We were about to go to Vienna for a chutti. So we went off to Vienna after giving the test. There in Vienna, standing alone outside the hotel, I see a message saying, you know, you have breast cancer, you'll have to get operated. So what did I do? I just told myself, kya karna hai? Isko bindas karna hai ki ro pit ke? Obviously, mere jeevan mein ek hi jawab hai, bindas karna. I went back into the hotel, my friends were all partying. I did not tell a single person. I did not even tell my husband. I said, "Who masti kar raha hai? Aaj usko let him have his, you know, fun." I told him the next morning. Baki group ko, we were 10 people traveling. I didn't tell anybody. I said, "Why spoil their chutti? Abhi to chutti shuru hui hai." So for 9 days, I stayed with them as if mujhe kuch nahi hua, and the biggest story of my life had happened to me alone. So that's the kind of person I am. I came back, got myself operated, didn't tell my friends. Tabhi, my argument was they will come back home and they'll be busy resettling. Why bother them? I got a lot of flack from it from my friends for, you know, for having done that. But this is who I am as a person. I do not give up or give in very easily. So I continued. I did my chemo. Bindas, I would go alone. Auto mein baith ke ya taxi mein baith ke alone I would go for chemo. वहाँ किशोर कुमार के गाने गाड़ियों में कीमो जा रहा है, देयर इज अ पोर्ट, यू नो, यू स्टिल सी द मार्क्स एंड पीपल आर बीइंग ब्रॉट फ्रॉम ऑल कैबिन्स टू शो मी। डॉक्टर्स लेके आ रहे हैं अपने अपने पेशेंट्स की, ये देखो ये भी एक पेशेंट है, कीमो चढ़ रहा है, किशोर गा रही है। सो ऐसे करते करते हमने निकाला और उसी दौरान आई स्टार्टेड वर्क ऑन द नेक्स्ट बुक। सो दैट वॉज फॉर मी द विक्ट्री। कीमो ऑलमोस्ट ख़त्म ही हुआ था, रेडिएशन शुरू हुआ, ऐसा कुछ था स्टोरी। आई स्टार्टेड वर्क ड्यूरिंग कीमो, आई थिंक आई स्टार्टेड वर्क ऑन माई बुक, स्टार्टेड मीटिंग पोटेंशियल पब्लिशर्स, स्टार्टेड सिटिंग एंड एडिटिंग द बुक। फॉर मी द बिग स्टोरी इन द ड्यूरिंग द कैंसर इज डूइंग द बुक।
So the biggest victory is you defeated cancer and you know something new evolved in you and you know you carried it forward.
Give up. I think thought rules everything.
Okay.
Thought अगर आपका सही है तो आपको कुछ नहीं हो सकता है, because a thought will manifest. The great pyramids of Giza was only a thought in somebody's mind. The Taj Mahal, the Hanging Gardens, सब सिर्फ thought था किसी के मन में। इतनी बड़ी चीज़, एक simple thought जिसको आप छू भी नहीं सकते, वो manifest हो गई। उसी तरह if you have a thought which says I will win, इससे मैं जीत जाऊंगी, देन कैंसर कुछ भी नहीं है।
अभी आप म्यूजिक बना रही हैं, यू आर हैविंग योर ओन एल्बम्स, वो किस नाम से आ रहा है अभी?
आई टुक ऑन एन आर्टिस्ट नेम, द नेम इज रसा। रसा इज द एसेंस ऑफ लाइफ, द नवरसा।
ओके।
सो आई कॉल माई सेल्फ रसा।
ओके।
एंड हाँ, रस्तफेरियन इज द रसा का सरनेम। रस्तफेरियन इज द नेम आई हैड कॉइंड फॉर माई फर्स्ट बुक। रस्ता इज लाइफ, Ferian is the guy who is wandering in life.
Okay.
So all of us are basically wanderers on this planet, isn't
right.
it? हम इस जीवन में हम केवल wander कर रहे हैं, फिर यूँ गायब हो जाएंगे ना, यूँ आए और यूँ चले जाए। So I call myself a Rastafarian. So I took on this moniker, Rasa Rastafarian. इस नाम से फिर गाना इस नाम से रिलीज़ किया।
अभी जो नया एल्बम आपका आप बना रहे हैं, यू आर वर्किंग ऑन इट, व्हाट इज इट ऑल अबाउट?
सी, इट्स बेसिकली टू एक्सप्लोर मल्टीपल इमोशंस, सेम नवरस को एक्सप्लोर कर रहे हैं। एवरी रस हैज अ सर्टन कलर एसोसिएटेड विद इट, एंड इन माय केस एवरी रस आल्सो हैज अ लैंग्वेज एसोसिएटेड विद इट। सो तमिल विल बी अ सर्टन कलर, मलयालम अ डिफरेंट कलर, बंगाली अ डिफरेंट कलर, जर्मन स्पैनिश फ्रेंच ऑफ कोर्स डिफरेंट कलर्स हिंदी उर्दू संस्कृत सबके अलग अलग रंग हैं मेरे जहन में अगैन टू यूज़ द वर्ड अगैन सो इमोशंस को आप एक्सप्लोर कर रहे हैं वेदर इट इज़ एनवी डिस्ट्रेस यू नो एंग्जायटी जॉय सो इट्स लाइक एक्सप्लोरिंग अ रेनबो ऑफ इमोशंस मल्टीपल कलर्स बट यू गो डीप इन टू योर सेल्फ टू अंडरस्टैंड इस इमोशन का मतलब एग्जैक्टली तेरे लिए क्या है रसा ग्रीन को तुम कैसे एक्सप्लेन करोगी वॉट इज ग्रीन फॉर यू फॉर एग्जाम्पल इज अ क्वेश्चन आई आस्क माई सेल्फ एंड देन समथिंग कम्स आउट ये एक्सप्लोरेशन है इट्स अ सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन का प्रोसेस
तो हमें कुछ सुनने के लिए मिल सकता है कैन वी यू नो
तो केवल हम केवल कोरस सुनाएंगे Years ago when I met you would I have known that you'd become therapy for me yeah. therapy for Years ago, when I met you, would I have known that you'd become therapy for me? Therapy.
थैंक यू सो मच संगीता जी आपने हमें टाइम दिया बहुत अच्छा म्यूज़िक सुनने को मिला अच्छी पोएट्री सुनने को मिली एंड यू नो वी स्टार्टेड यू नो नोइंग दैट लाइफ कैन बी लिव्ड इन सच अ वे सो इट वाज अ ग्रेट टाइम वी हैड इन इंडिया डेज यू नो वी आर वेरी लकी टुडे कि इतनी प्रतिभाशाली इतनी वर्सेटाइल और डाइवर्स पर्सनैलिटी के साथ आज हमने बात करी थैंक यू संगीता जी एंड वी विल बी इन टच अगैन